talking about assimilation. Now, do not get confused between this assimilation in case of amines and the Friedel-Crafts assimilation. Friedel-Crafts assimilation is an electrophilic substitution reaction. If you remember, electrophile was generated in case of Friedel-Crafts assimilation, while this assimilation in case of amines is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. That means attack by a nucleophile takes place, attack by a negative reagent takes place. So let's do the mechanism. For example, I am taking the example of ethanamine C2H5NH2 with a lone pair of electrons over the nitrogen atom. We know that in case of acylation, what do we use? We use CH3COCl, which is ethanoyl chloride, or we also call it as acetyl chloride or acetyl chloride. Okay, when this is reacted with CH3C(OCl), what happens in the first step is that this bond is polar, the pair of electrons is shifted here, this becomes negative and this becomes positive, this becomes the electrophilic center. The negative portion, that is the electron pair, it will attack the positive center, it will attack the electrophilic center, thus giving rise to C2H5. Both the hydrogens of the nitrogen atom, I am drawing like this, both these hydrogens which are attached to the nitrogen atom, this nitrogen will be now directly connecting to this carbon atom, this particular electrophilic center, which is attached to double bond O, which has now become O minus because one pair of electrons has shifted on the oxygen atom. Another group it is having is CH3 group, and the third thing it is having is Cl. Now, because there are four bonds around this nitrogen atom, it will develop a positive charge. Your next step over here will be to disperse its positive charge. The nitrogen takes away this electron pair from hydrogen. This negative charge comes back here to get stabilized, and this leaves in order to satisfy the valency of carbon atom. So what do you get? C2H5, this has become N1H here. It has got back its lone pair of electrons. From here, H has been released. This bond comes like this. It becomes C double bond over here. Cl has left, so this carbon has just one more CH3. Now, two things have been released from this particular compound. One is H and the other is Cl. So, the byproduct that you are going to get in this particular reaction is HCl. Fine. Now, how you are going to name this particular compound? If I write it in the condensed form, it will be written as C2H5NH COCH3. If you see this particular thing and hide this part, what do you find is this is CH3CONH. Fine. CONH, what kind? Had there been no such group over here, it would have been CH3CONH2. CH3CONH2 is what? CH3CONH2 is what? This is the amide group and two carbon atoms. So this will be called as ethanamide. But if you see, one hydrogen atom of ethanamide has been substituted by the ethyl group. Now this ethyl group is present on the nitrogen atom. So how you will be naming this compound is N to the nitrogen atom. What is attached? My ethyl group. So I will write it as N ethyl. And what is my main chain? Ethanamide. So I will call it as N-ethylethanamide. This is how you're going to name this particular compound. Okay, now this reaction, it takes place in the presence of a base, pyridine. pyridine is a base. You need not do the structure of pyridine for class 12. You only need to remember is that pyridine is a base, not a very strong base, a simple weak base. Now, why this base is being used in this particular reaction? This is often asked in the reasoning part. Now, what happens is we can see that an acid is being generated in the reaction. This base has been added to neutralize this acid. That means as soon as HCl is formed, the base immediately neutralizes this acid. When it is neutralizing this acid, the concentration of HCl goes on decreasing. When the concentration of HCl goes on decreasing, what will happen? As per the Lee-Chatelier's principle, the reaction will move in the forward direction so as to nullify the effect of this change. So for this reaction to move, to keep moving in the forward direction, we add the base pyridine over here.